Good morning, dear students, and welcome to the new academic session 2021. So, since you are in class 9, now you will be doing a new subject, environmental science, about which you must be aware. So, we will be today trying to understand the syllabus of class 9, what all aspects of environmental science you are supposed to cover under this particular new subject. So, what I will do today is, I will tell you in brief the introduction to environmental science, which is also our first chapter of environmental science, right? So, the first chapter of environmental science, that itself is understanding our environment. We try to understand our environment, the problems that exist in the environment, and how we can mitigate or look for solutions to those particular problems that the entire globe is today facing. So, before we jump into the problems of the environment, it is very important for you to understand what is environmental science, this new subject that you are doing. So, your textbook has also discussed the first question that will arise in your mind, what is environmental science? Okay, so environmental science, this subject, is not a single subject in itself, but it's a combination of many subjects together, taken together under one roof, and we call it environmental science. So you have to have idea to geography, you have to have idea to chemistry, physics, and lots of other subjects in order to understand environmental science. So basically, environmental science, when we see, it tries to teach us how man interacts with nature, how we are dependent on the natural resources around us. So the first part of your chapter says, environmental science is the study of interaction of man to his immediate environment. What do we mean by man interacting to his environment? We are dependent on soil, air, water, forest, and lots of other resources in the environment. You cannot survive as an individual, you cannot survive without soil, which gives you agricultural output. Can you survive without air? No, definitely not. We breathe in oxygen, we give out carbon dioxide. So air is another important resource that man needs to survive. So in this way, if you see your life from morning to night, you are actually all dependent on the resources of the environment. From the very morning, the toothbrush that you use, the paste that you use to brush and cleanse your teeth, they all come from the resources of the environment. The food that you are eating is a product of nature. The bed on which you sleep is a product of nature. The cosmetics or other products that you are using in your daily life, they are all products of nature. Right? So, what we need to do is, why this subject has become very important is, as students, you need to realize that it is very important to protect the environment. Since environment is degrading day by day, the way people have behaved with nature, the way man has interacted negatively with nature, we have destroyed nature to such an extent that many things are today irreversible. You cannot make it normal again. There is global warming and acid rain and pollution and so many disorders in the environment you must have heard about. So these disorders can only be treated if man today becomes aware of what wrong we are doing to the nature, right? That is why it is very important as students to understand and become aware of what is happening in nature and what is environment, how your life can also get affected because of the problems in the environment, right? So we will be discussing, I have told you what is environmental science. It is interaction of man to nature. So what has happened is, why we are studying the subject is because of our negative interaction with nature. And because of negatively interacting with nature, we have created a lot of problems in the environment. So we will try to understand what problems have we created in the environment, the environmental problems, the basic environmental problems that exist in nature today. The first one is resource depletion. Depletion, degradation. We are losing natural resources. One simple example, if we take forest, we are losing a very important resource, the forest. Why are we losing? Because man's population is increasing. When human population increases, we create deforestation to make the human settlements, to make industries and to make roads and many other things that man requires. And because of that, what happens is we lose resources in our environment. And once forests disappear, it is not the trees only which are disappearing, but numerous other things which reside inside the forest. The second one, if you see, there is loss of biodiversity. So it is all related. When we say we lose forest, biodiversity means the flora and fauna which is found inside the forest. So all these basic flora and fauna also we are losing, that is plants and animals, right? So when we lose the forest, plants and animals lose their habitat and we are losing biodiversity. And I just told you sometime back that life of man is dependent on biodiversity. The more diversity you have, the more rich we are. Right? So when we lose biodiversity, when we start losing plants and animals, then what happens is the next problem that arises is that of pollution. What do trees do? They not only provide a natural habitat to plants and animals, they are not only providing a natural habitat to plants and animals, but they are also controlling pollution. You must be knowing that, that trees control pollution. We call forest as sink, carbon sink. If there is a too much of carbon dioxide in nature, it is very harmful to man. But what do trees do? They absorb the carbon dioxide. So nature remains pure and fresh when the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the trees. So you have to have lots and lots of greenery in the environment. But what have we done? We have lost biodiversity, because of which there is a lot of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, and that creates pollution. Pollution first and foremost is affecting man. We are suffering from various ailments and various diseases because of pollution, right? Then ozone depletion is another. What happens because of pollution is ozone depletion. The ozone layer that is there in the stratosphere, that also has been destroyed because of a chemical that is CFC, that is chlorofluorocarbons. You must have heard about this in class 8. Chlorofluorocarbons, this group of compound which is released from refrigerators and air coolers and plastic manufacturing industries, foam making industries, it found its application in many, many places. But later, research proved that these CFC went into the stratosphere and created holes and pockets in the ozone layer. Now, why are we talking of the ozone layer? Because it is something very significant. Ozone layer is an important layer in the stratosphere because it prevents the ultraviolet rays from penetrating Earth. If the UV rays from the sun start penetrating Earth, then life will not be possible. Life on Earth is possible only because of the presence of ozone layer, because that ozone layer traps the ultraviolet rays of the sun and keeps it there. So we are alive. Now what has happened because of pollution? Even the ozone layer has been depleted. We will talk about detail about the depletion of ozone layer in other chapters. Then the next problem that mankind is facing is that of deforestation. I told you, deforestation leads to climate change. How is deforestation related to climate change? When you cut down the trees, I told you, the CO2 level increases, carbon dioxide level increases, and when that increases, that carbon dioxide results in global warming. The warming that is occurring all over the globe, that is the increase in the annual temperature, that is called global warming, and that happens when carbon dioxide forms a layer in the troposphere. Carbon dioxide has nowhere to go. So what has happened is CO2 has formed a layer in the troposphere, and because of that, the rays of the sun which come to the earth, they are not able to escape back. That leads to global warming. So the climate has drastically changed because of deforestation. Then all the pollutants that we are creating from industries and factories, they all go to the rivers, and the river water then joins the ocean. And what has happened to the oceans nowadays? They are acidified. The water has become acidic. That is called ocean acidification. Okay, so even the ocean water has been acidified, because of which what is happening is the aquatic flora and fauna are very badly suffering. So we are losing the ocean resources as well. Overfishing, too much of extraction of fishes for commercial reason, is another problem that we are facing. So when we take out too much of fishes for consumption, for man's consumption, the aquatic ecosystem is imbalanced. There is an imbalance in the ecosystem. So I have given you a brief idea to the environmental. There are numerous other problems that man is facing. These are some of the problems that man is facing today. So in today's class, we try to understand why we are studying this subject, environmental science. What is environmental science? And I tried to tell you the problems that man has created because of destruction and negative interaction with nature. So I will be sending you the syllabus, and I will be discussing the mitigation measures in the next lecture. Thank you.